Good evening, everyone. After his fishing boat capsizes in the ocean and with waves crashing over him for 18 hours, a Lenexa man survives. He returns home tonight to the hugs and kisses of his family. KMBC 9's Martin Augustine has the story. Martin?
Larry, Randy Waldorf says before this weekend he was very thankful for the good things in his life, but after this weekend, that sense of thanks is even more crystal clear. Smiling and walking into the arms of his wife, Kathy, Randy Waldorf arrives home, a moment of serenity that, considering where he'd come from only a few hours ago, might have seemed so remote in the hours before this photo was snapped on Saturday of a Coast Guard rescue boat carrying Waldorf and his two friends to safety. There you see Waldorf on the top left, moments before the rescue boats pulled aboard a Coast Guard cutter.
It set in this morning what we went through.
Now, just off his flight back home, he says he will never forget his rescue by the Coast Guard, never forget all the hugs on shore, just as he'll never forget when he and his friends Arlen Gastineau and Ken Harper hit the water Friday night when their boat capsized 25 miles from shore.
We said a prayer, I'll tell you, we said a prayer almost as soon as we hit the water, and you know, I said several more throughout the evening. And
jellyfish stings on his arms, scars from 18 hours in the ocean, along with sore muscles from the constant grip they had on ropes holding them close to the boat, ended when a Coast Guard airplane spotted the three men. Waldorf's wife, Kathy, soon had the news.
Finally got the call that they were on board a boat and out of the water, and they were all alive.
Alive and well, and back in the embrace of his family.
I certainly have a lot to be thankful for, and I knew that before. It certainly puts things in perspective. No reason to sweat the small stuff.
Waldorf says the boat developed engine problems on Friday night. That's why it capsized. But because the group had told people on shore about where they were going to be fishing, they felt all along that they would be rescued. Larry?
Martin, what about future fishing trips for Randy Waldorf?
Well, he says he's not going to rule out future trips. He's not going to book one for a while, though. And his wife, Kathy, says she may exercise some veto power over some of those trips.
That doesn't surprise me. Thank you, Martin. Well, one of the three fishermen, Arlen Gastineau of Orlando, Florida, was still hospitalized this morning, but Waldorf says that Gastineau appeared much improved when he saw him prior to catching his flight home.